Lei here from leifirstsci.com, and in this video, I will show you how to name a molecule that has both an alkene and an alkyne. Recall that an alkene is a molecule that has a carbon-to-carbon double bond and gets the last name of ene, and an alkyne is a molecule that has a carbon-to-carbon triple bond and gets the last name of ine. But how do you name a molecule that has both a double bond and a triple bond? An alkene and alkyne can exist in the same molecule, and you prioritize based on where each functional group shows up. We'll use this molecule as our first example. Since I only have one long chain, I highlight my parent chain and then decide how to number. I have the option of numbering from the left, giving me a 1 for the double bond, or numbering from the right, giving me a 2 for the triple bond. The priority here is determined by which functional group you hit first, and so I have to number from the left because I have number 1, which is lower than 2. Having 6 carbons in my chain gives me a first name of hex. Having both a double and a triple bond, I get 2 last names for this molecule. I get a 1-ene for the double bond and a 4-ine for the triple bond. When it comes to putting the molecule together, ene gets a higher priority than ine in the naming, and that is because in alphabetical order, E comes before Y. In previous examples, we've shown that you could put the number before the name, but because we have 2 last names here, each number has to precede its specific functional group. This gives me a complete name of hex1-ene-4-ine. In this example, I switched the order of the substituents so that once again we have a straight chain with an alkene and an alkyne, but in this molecule, since the alkyne is terminal, the alkyne gets priority for numbering, and so I number starting from the right. Once again, 6 carbons gives me a first name of hex, and the double bond and triple bond give me a last name of both 1-ine and 4-ene. In this case, even though the triple bond has higher priority for numbering, E comes before Y, and so ene still comes before ine in the name. And so the molecule is named hex4-ene-1-ine. Now what happens if I have an example that potentially gives the alkene and the alkyne the same name? Once again, I start by highlighting my parent chain, but now I have the option of numbering from the right, giving the triple bond the number 2, or numbering from the left, giving the double bond the number 2. In this situation, the alkene has the higher priority than the alkyne, and so we start numbering from the left. Having 7 carbons in my molecule gives me a first name of hept. Having both an alkene and an alkyne gives me the last name of 2-ene and another last name of 5-ine. Since E comes before Y, I get a final name of hept2-ene-5-ine. Now let's look at this example. The first thing I do is highlight my parent chain and determine which way to number. Going back to the standard IUPAC rules, you have to number the chain so that the substituent gets the lowest number. In this case, I have to start numbering from the right because I have a methyl group on the second carbon. Now let's put the name together. I have 8 carbons giving me a first name of oct. I have a double bond on carbon 5 giving me a last name of 5-ene. I also have a triple bond on 3 giving me a second last name of 3-ine, and then we have a methyl group on carbon 2 giving me the prefix 2-methyl. When putting this molecule together, methyl is your only substituent, therefore it's your prefix. Ene and ine are both your last names and sorted in alphabetical order. This gives me a final name of 2-methyl-oct-5-ene-3-ine. Are you struggling with organic chemistry? Are you looking for information to guide you through the course and help you succeed? If so, download my ebook, 10 Secrets to Acing Organic Chemistry, using the link below, or visit leifirstsci.com/orgosecrets. That's O-R-G-O secrets. For information regarding online tutoring, visit leifirstsci.com/orgotutor. That's O-R-G-O tutor. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and even share it with a friend or two. If you have any questions regarding this video, leave a comment below or contact me through my Facebook page at facebook.com/leifirstsci. There will be many related videos posted over the course of the semester, so go ahead and click the subscribe button to ensure that you don't miss out.